Hey gang, Izzy Noodles back again with the final part of Waterfall Valley. Unfortunately, this is a shorter game, and now I don't have the limit on the length of my videos like I did when I first started out. Waterfall Valley has flown by this time, so this game will only be in two parts. Even for the other games that I will be replaying, because I mentioned that I'm going to replay the other games I've done, but with commentary this time. I'll try and do fewer videos so they have longer parts, and that's simply to be able to have more newer games uploaded and not linger on the ones you've seen before. But having said that, I would like to have longer videos anyway, just because it does get more videos out and you get to see more game time. So I'll do my best with that, but there will be some exceptions to the rules. But anyway, let's continue. Where were we? So here we are. I've done the nasty death traps and I have... I'm going to call that 2%. 2% health left. And that's absolutely fine because this rest of the game is pretty easy. So we picked up a gold idol and a cog in the underwater area, and the gold idol goes right here. So you may assume that it goes in the doorway, it opens the door, but it doesn't. It raises this. So if you climb on up, you want to be central, so you can grab that pole in front, run and jump. And when you release, you want to veer to the left and not grab in the air. So if you look across there, there is an item there, so let's go and have a look, see what that's about. So you want to jump and grab to be able to hop up here. And shimmying does take some time. There we go, so just drop, and here we go, we have the shotgun. Awesome. Hop on down. And that's actually not the reason you go up onto that higher ledge, so unfortunately we're going to have to climb up again, I'm afraid. No matter, no matter. So same again, be central. When you release, veer to the left, do not press grab. So here we go, this jump can be tricky. Just if you look at the line on Lara's left hand side by her foot, just walk along and see if you pretty much line up with the line all the way across. That's near enough for me, so just do a run and jump. And you will certainly grab this. You won't veer off to one side because that camera angle is a bit tedious. So we've spawned a pterodactyl. I was trying to pick up that pickup straight in front, but never mind. So they take 3 or 4 shots. The closer they are, the less shots they take. And so just grab that pickup that I just did. That was Uzi ammo. And then drop to grab this jump switch. And this gate's now open. So I'm gonna save just in case something bad happens. Because it might. So there will be most likely lots of saving now I don't have very good health. Also gonna equip my Uzis. Got a couple of raptors in here. Awesome. How much? Oh, 14 bullets. Very nice. Okay, so in here to the left there is some revolver ammo. And you've got this little cave inside the cave, I suppose. There is a cog by the skeleton, and over here there is the revolver. And you see on the wall here, this is where we're going to place our cogs. I'm going to place two of them for now, just because. You really don't have to place them now. There we go. So we're just making Lara's backpack a bit lighter. Okay, so you can see up the top there is a lever. You want to be able to get up there. So you have to push this crate to get up there. And you have to zigzag about with this crate. She can't push it through grass. So it's very zigzaggy. Sometimes you might think, why didn't I just push it a different way? But you can only push it this way. The way I am doing it. So you just push it now all the way to the wall. Alright. So if you hop on, we now can reach this up here. And we've got a pole rope swing combo going on here. So it's pretty easy to... what's the word? Use. Just gonna say use. And you just want to be ever so slightly to one side, not a lot. There we go, simple as. So use the floor lever and it will show you what we've done. Okay. So we are heading straight there right now. Unfortunately, it is across the other side of the valley. So just sprint and roll. Mix things up, sprinting and rolling. Okay. So you want to climb up here. Sometimes she might not grab. She needs to be in a specific position to climb up here. So you can see a jump switch there, so that's an indication that we want to climb up here. And when we do spawn a pterodactyl, so don't hang around. So you see two things have happened there. Let me just choose my shotgun. Okay, so that deactivated a spike trap, so we can go to get that now, or we can go in here now. I will firstly be going in here, and I'm going to save, because there's actually bats in here, and if you have this much health, bats in TRLEs can be very nasty. You also get a couple of compies. You spawn both of them when you step on the tile in that doorway. Not this doorway straight in front, but the one ahead. So I jump and turn in the air and hop backwards. Exactly like that. Okay, so if you jump backwards from here, you will land on that ledge, and it gives you just that extra bit of height and distance. So I find that helpful. Also, there are a lot of ladder textures in here. Only this one can be climbed. So you want Lara's feet just below the greenery, and flip back, and you will flip right into this gap and claim a secret. So just hop on out. You won't take any damage by falling down. And you may think you can shoot that great, but no, just swim on under. Awesome. I don't know why I said awesome. I think I say it too much. Okay. Wow, Lara, what are you doing? There you go. I think she has a problem with water. now, equipping my revolver, I'm just cycling through the weapons just to give them a chance to be used. You got a native tribesman in here, just a couple of shots from the revolver will do, and you've got some more revolver ammo in this hut. And in the next hut, you've got a couple more of these natives. Where's the other guy? Awesome! So if we have a look in here, we've got some spikes and a laser sight over here. Just be very careful of the fire. So now just come around into this corner area, and you want to combine the laser sight and the revolver, and you want to shoot that there. Wanted to do an awesome dive, but it didn't work. So now we can access this lever, but it's not shown as what it does. If you pull it again, it will actually undo what it's done. So try not to pull it too many times, otherwise you might get a bit confused. You'll never find out what it's done. So in... wow. Come on, Lara. So in this second hut, these spikes are now gone, and we can move the skeleton out the way. Out the way. There we go. He was sat on a cog. So now we've got another cog. There's nothing more to do in here, so we can just leave the area. So now the next thing to do is to find where we deactivated those spikes. And that's actually straight on top of the doorway that we previously came from. So just run all the way across again. Here we go. What are you turning for, Lara? So just hop on up. And if you'd come up here before, you would have been impaled. But now we can grab this key. And when you hop down, you want to press action. Otherwise she might just overshoot this block and crunch. So now we've got the key. Just run all the way back over to the other doorway. And you can actually see the keyhole. That's where the key will go, and it will raise that platform above it. So that's now raised and we can stand on that. But before I do that, I completely forgot about this med pack over in this corner. Alright, so now we can hop on up there. Okay, so there is actually nothing you can do about this camera angle, so this is quite a tricky jump. So aim a little to the left, but not too much. You're probably better off aiming to the right, because then you won't actually kill yourself. So you just want to do a standing jump. There we go, that was pretty damn perfect. And now run and jump to here. And you're just running and jumping over the ledges here. And you've got these really tedious poles. So, you want to be as far as you can into the corner. And don't forget, the poles in this particular game are only really grabbable from the centre. So, by all means, save your game. So when you jump from this first one, you want to veer to the left. That's the first time I've made that jump on the first go. That was pretty epic. And now we're heading behind this stupid bit of rock that's just sticking out and in the way. So if you look at where I positioned Lara's feet, you see there's a black bit to the left behind her, like a darker patch. So if you want to be sort of the front of there, forward a bit from there, this is how I try and do a running jump. So I'm definitely going to save. And if you do it right, you should land straight on the thing. There we go. That was awesome. And the only thing up here is this second mask. So you want to hop down, but just shimmy to the right so you don't take any fall damage. This part is slightly lower. Now run on in here, mind the fire. This is where we use the two masks that we picked up. So using these will open this door, and behind the door is a velociraptor. So I like to use my revolver. Usually takes four shots. I think I hit the wall there. But inside you see there's TNT, so that's pretty exciting. And in this little grassy bit, got some Uzi clips. And now you just want to hop on up, so just climb the block so you can reach the ledge. Pretty straightforward how to get up. And over here there is a note. So I won't read the note, I'll open it up. If you want to read it, pause the game. So, when I did a walkthrough before without commentary, I showed you a bug. So I'll show it to you again just because it just makes me laugh. So you want to be on the higher part of here and just simply jump. There you go, straight back up again. So from here, you want to grab the rope swing to make your way to the other side. There we go, and you've got a door here. There's also one on the other side, and you might assume that you need to open the door, but that's actually not the case. We do not open that door or the other one. The only thing up here is the detonator key. And we can use that straight away just here. That, get that out of the way. And here's the detonator. So unfortunately we do not get to see any explosions. Bit of a shame, but never mind. Also, you see you've got another secret there, so I will come to that in a moment. Let's firstly see what we've done here. We have made a right mess. Look at that. And in here we've got a choice of two cogs to pick up. We only want one. But there is absolutely no hint of which one to pick up. So let me demonstrate. If you pick up the one on the left, you will get a rather nasty booty poke. Look at that. That's pretty grim. So the moral of the story is don't pick up the one on the left, because you'll die. So pick up the one on the right. I mean, there is no hint of which one you want. There really isn't. But now, if we come back to the idea of the secret, there is a crawl space there. But Lara can't actually enter that. But if you have a look, there's a vase down there. There we go, so just shoot the vase. And that has opened the gate to the secret. So here it is, our last secret. So from here we have our four cogs and we're going to use them. So we're going straight back to the wall, the cog wall, in the first area. So just sprint all the way along, all the way across. Here we go. Here we are. So, just placed your last two cogs. So, it's not obvious what that's done, but the moment you come out here, you can see there is now a huge block here that wasn't here before. To jump onto it, you actually want to jump onto the slope. The sloop behind. And hop on up to here. And now we have a very short timer. This lever is timed. I will save and then I will show you what it does. So once you pull it, the way I do it is I hop and turn and then turn just a little bit more. And then do a standing jump onto this first platform, run and jump to the next, and then run and jump straight round to the left. You want to veer to the left and grab. So here we go, let's try this. There we go, so that will take some practices. If you miss, you will most likely crunch. With this amount of health, you will definitely crunch. So you just shimmy along until you reach this jump switch. Okay. So we know exactly where that is. That is right here. So just pull this lever. Awesome. So now this door that was over here, you may have spotted it earlier, this is now open. I say you may have spotted it, you probably didn't. But just run on through here, and this is actually the end of the level. So, thank you for watching, I hope you've enjoyed Waterfall Valley. This is actually so far my second favourite TRLE, and it was the first that I played. It says to be continued, but I have a strong feeling that it won't, because it's been so long since this one was made. But thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time. Take it easy, guys.